Hi, it's Sandra Dee, founder of Charisma on Camera, where we help experts like yourself look and feel like a rock star every time you get in front of a TV or a video camera. And welcome to Big Impact. Okay, guys, so today I just thought I'm gonna sit here and have a little chat with you. I'm gonna talk to you about fascination and why it is so important to keep that fascination in your message so that you can engage your audience. What is she talking about? Okay, let me explain. A long time ago, I had my favorite acting coach just kind of like throw something off the cuff, and it stuck with me. He said, fascinated people are fascinating. Now, what he meant in that context was that we as actors, you know, should be in our character and be fascinated with our purpose in the scene. Because if we're fascinated with that purpose, we'd be that much more engaging for the audience to watch. Okay, now hang on. What is it that you want? You want your audience to be engaged. So because I'm so fascinated, and I have been for so long, with animal and human behavior, as soon as he said this, I started thinking, where else does this show up in my life? And you know, it's funny, I still notice things just randomly that I go, yep, somebody's fascination got me. I mean, for example, have you ever been at a gathering somewhere and somebody that maybe has a line of business that you wouldn't really be interested in is so interested in what he does and so fascinated with it that the next thing you know, you're really enjoying the conversation. Maybe your eyes were even open up to a different business that you didn't even think you would be interested in participating in, but all of a sudden there you are, maybe joint venturing with a guy. Hey, stranger things have happened, you know. Here's a kind of an odd situation, but I have to admit, it proved my point. I was sitting at a Starbucks and I had my coffee and I'm in Santa Monica, California, everybody. And there's a homeless man who's walking by. Now, what's odd is that I couldn't keep my eyes off of him. He was fascinated completely, completely consumed in a conversation with an imaginary person. But I digress. Because of his fascination with this conversation, he really was 100% devoted to it. And even if it wasn't real, he was fascinated. And yeah, I couldn't stop watching this guy. And it was interesting because other folks that were sitting out there outside there with me too were doing the same thing, holding their cups of coffee and just watching him. Now, if it works for him, imagine how powerful it would be if you just harnessed that yourself. You may say it's easier said than done because there may be a few things standing in your way. One of them could be fear. So the first thing I have to say is use the exercise that I have in my basic training, in my foundational training, to help you connect with exactly who it is that you want to see the change in and talk through that camera lens straight to them. Now, if you don't know what I'm talking about, then you have to get the foundational training. It's free. It's on the website. So just go to charismaoncamera.com and just sign in up at the top and we'll send it straight to you. And then you'll know what I'm talking about when I talk about these exercises. But to be able to do that exercise, really picture who you're going to be talking to and who you're going to be gifting your message to. Those are the people that you can change. You can actually change somebody's life, and that's what you need to be focused on them, not you. That'll help you get over the fear. Now, the next thing is, how do you really connect and show that fascination? Well, if you've noticed, there seems to be a real movement towards really being authentic in your message. Really just being natural and coming from the heart and sharing your purpose. But if you're not comfortable with that, you're going to have to do a little practice with it. You're going to have to talk about the things that fascinate you. Even if it means just putting yourself in front of the camera without actually having a deliberate video that you need to have done, but just talking to it as if you would your best friend or your best client and sharing why you're so fascinated with your purpose and with your business. Now, another problem you may have, maybe you're not feeling passionate. Maybe you just got to do this video for your business and you might have burned out on it right now. Maybe you just can't seem to drum that up. You can't seem to connect and you still feel like that fish out of water or like you're in a foreign land and you just can't get that excitement going. Here's something you can do. Incorporate passions you have outside of your business. If you love dance, start to use some dance verbiage in your message. If you love baseball, do the same thing. Start talking about, you know, first base, second base, and what that means to you in your business. There are ways that you can incorporate words and phrases and even movements to things that you love. Even metaphors, come to think of it, to things that you love outside of your business, and that will help you to connect a little bit. Now, some of you are going, oh, well, wait, I don't want to alienate anybody. What if somebody's watching and they don't like baseball? What if somebody's watching and they might think differently of me if they know that I dance? Here's something to really think about. If you can bring in more customers, let's just say this month, if you could get 30 new customers, would you rather have the customers that you click with? Would you rather have the customers that maybe share some of your passions? Not that you have to, but it might make your life a little bit more pleasant, wouldn't it? If you kind of know the same plane with somebody, it makes things a little easier. So don't worry about sharing your passions and worry about who's gonna connect and who's not. Your right people, your fans and your followers are gonna be right there with you. That's kind of helping you to create that really strong visual brand. And it's helping you feel more authentic in the moment so that you can share information and we can be more engaged. Here's the thing. When we as your audience get engaged, you have that rapport with us. That's when you can ask somebody to take that call to action. That's when you can get people to move. That's what you're doing in front of the video in the first place. You want to be able to change people's lives, move them to action, to purchase, to join you, to give to your charity, whatever it's going to be. You need to have that rapport with them. So start by sharing your fascination. It's fun for you, and it's a lot more fun for us to watch. So if any of this resonates with you, or you have any questions, or maybe you even have some ideas for things that can help people really touch into that passion for themselves, leave it down below here in the comment section. We'd love to hear from you. If you have any questions, I'll be sure to answer them. I just really look forward to hearing what you have to say. So until next time, make it a great, great week, and we'll see you next time on Big Impact. Bye. That's exactly what you want too. You want to engage the audience. So, so close. But would love to hear from you. Until next time. Until next time, what? Nate's with you, and if any of it. Shut off now.